Bees can be cute little critters. Sure, they can sting you and cause pain, but they don't mean to. They've got much more important work to do. Firstly, we all know that bees make honey, which is delicious and can be good for your health. They also make beeswax, which we use in things like candles, furniture polish, and skincare. But most importantly, bees play a crucial role for all of us, the pollination of plants. They really are busy bees. Let's explain. When a bee lands on a flower, they do two things. First, they suck the sweet, sweet nectar, a kind of sugary juice from the flower. They keep it in their stomach and then vomit it up to other bees in the hive. Gross, I know. But eventually, that becomes honey. Sorry if I ruined your breakfast. Okay, so as they do that, the bees also collect pollen, the part of the male plant that helps it reproduce when spread to female plants. It's sort of like the bees help mum and dad plants have babies. Cute. The bees have little tiny hairs on their back legs known as pollen baskets. They gather nectar and pollen and move on to the next flower to help the next lot of mum and dad plants. The bee is done once it has close to its own body weight in nectar and pollen, and then, amazingly, flies home. Think about that. Imagine if you had to carry a backpack with you in it. Then you had to fly somewhere. It's crazy, but they do it. The bees are super hard workers doing all they can to make sure their hive has important food for babies and themselves. Plus, they also make sure plants can grow and grow through pollination, which is what really helps us. We'd have a lot less food. We'd have no onions, almonds, or even avocados. And there'd be heaps less cucumbers, mangoes, apples, pumpkins, the list goes on and on. Plus, bees don't just help fruit and veg, they love to fly to a plant called lucerne, or hay, which is the favourite food for animals like cattle. Okay, so pollination by bees is super important to us, but our humble little bees are under threat. Oh no! Worldwide, there are more than 20,000 different types of bees, and 1,600 of them can only be found in Australia. We have the world's smallest, this little guy, the teensy-tiny quasi-hesma bee. And then we have this big fella, the tropical carpenter bee. Oh, he's a gentle giant. But mostly, in Australia, we get honey, and that important pollination, from Western and European honeybees. They've been living and working here for more than 200 years. But their cousins around the world are in the struggle of their lives. Entire hives are dying in what's called colony collapse disorder. It's a really sad situation where all the worker bees suddenly disappear, leaving the queen on her own with just a few nurse bees. Her poor majesty. We don't fully know what causes it, but scientists believe it's a combination of big problems like pesticides, pollution, and other bugs such as mites. Those mites are really bad for bees. They're like bees' enemy number one. Right now, Australia is the only country in the whole world that doesn't have these bee-killing bugs. But it's a battle to keep it that way. Very clever bee scientists and bee police are working hard to keep rival foreign bees like the African and Asian honeybees from spreading in Australia. Those bees are much more aggressive than the ones we have. They rob existing hives for honey and can carry diseases that our bees don't know how to get better from. Right now, Australia is making sure these pests don't make it to our shores. They're setting up special empty hives near ports where those naughty bees might try to sneak into Australia, and they're catching them there. It's important work because we need our bees to help us make delicious food that's still cheap for us all. Because if all our bees go, we won't have honey, and definitely no honey chicken. And if the bees go, we need to help our mum and dad plants pollinate by doing it by hand, like they have to do in some parts of China where all the bees are gone. So there are little things you can do to help our humble bee. You can keep enjoying honey so our beekeepers can continue helping hives do their work. Make sure you plant and look after flowers, veggies and herbs of all kind. And if you can, hang up a bee hotel like this. It's just holes drilled in timber, or you can get a fancy one from the shops. Our native bees love to have a little holiday in them, put their tiny legs up and rest before getting back to their busy day. It's our turn to help protect these little critters who do so much important work for us. So, be kind to bees, or you will be in trouble.